So what we can do is we can go over to our input menu, just like we do in HECRATUS, we can say draw cross section, and we can have it automatically name our section. Now in HECHMS, they only have one cross section per reach. So what people prefer to do is they want to have the cross section ID match the river or the reach ID. So it'll do that automatically. Define your data source. Tell it how much data you want to extract. So I want to cut these sections maybe 20 feet deep. Let it go out to 1,000 feet to make that happen. Have it figure out our bank stations well. Do it based on channel depth. Let's say 3 feet is probably okay. Maximum search distance. Or if you've already got polylines, you can go and map those in. Define your roughness values. Then just click on draw. And just like in GeoHECRATUS, just draw a line wherever you want your section to go. Right click, say done. And there's your section, right? So there, now we can take a look at our section. Double click on it. And it comes up with your equivalent 8-point section that you want. Now here it's pretty poor. So I might want to change it. I might say, well, I want to make it 5 feet and it'll go and revise that. Or if I want to go in here and manually edit it, click on your little pencil tool and you can come up with your equivalent 8-point section that way. Or in HECHMS, they now have something which is called a tabular cross section, which is basically takes your cross section geometry and converts it into an equivalent section that has, I think, up to 100 points in it. So this section mimics this other section, the real section there. So it automatically... Go ahead.
Mimics it hydraulically.
Exactly, exactly. So it's mimicking it hydraulically equivalent. So it's calculating your top width, your flow area, and your discharge curve. Now that's been in HECHMS for a while, but no one uses it because you got to manually calculate all this. Whereas in our software, it's done. You know, you don't have to do that grunt work. It's done. It's taken care of. And again, if you're using InfoSwim wants this, right? They either want to have the original cross-section geometry, or they want the trapezoidal geometry, or whatever. You know, they want pipes as well and stuff like that. But you can port this stuff over to the swim stuff. All right, so we'll close it up. But a lot of times, if you have a whole bunch of these to do, you know, sometimes you just want to have a simple trapezoid, right? So let's just take